My father would tell me of a time before we left the Earth, when we were still confined to the surface of the planet. But our curiosity soon changed that. Human ingenuity soon carried us aloft, as our dreams of building a road to the stars propelled our first cosmonauts and astronauts into orbit.
Roger, 0G, and I feel fine.
By the time I was born, our first space stations were already circling the Earth. Learning how to engineer for everything we needed to live beyond the biosphere. And I grew up dreaming of such adventures and challenges. These dreams propelled me into science and on to become an engineer. Joining the quest to build better systems for supporting life in space and even more ambitious space stations. Attempting to live for years away from the Earth taught us one thing. This common challenge of living permanently beyond the planet is a truly international endeavor.
2, 1, boost to ignition and liftoff, returning to the space station, paving the way for future missions beyond.
Together we found a way to build this dream, working as a single global team for one peaceful goal. Since the first habitable modules were launched over 17 years ago, more than 220 people have visited the International Space Station. Living, working, and maintaining our new home. A permanent human presence beyond the planet. As an engineer, I'm proud to say that I've contributed to this great project to push the human spirit outwards. And as we build humanity's new road back to the moon and on to Mars, we are here in low Earth orbit to stay. Today, over 15 years on, the International Space Station is as much a laboratory as it is a spaceship. And today's visitors are scientists, engineers, and medics, in addition to being astronauts. A unique, world-class science facility for the benefit of all mankind. The technology used to track a patient's eye and precisely direct the laser scalpel for surgery to correct eyesight was first developed for use in space. This underwater robot, developed to train for spacewalks in neutral buoyancy pools on Earth, is now being tested in the Mediterranean Sea for potential mining applications and for locating lost aircraft black boxes. And learning how to sustain human life in orbit has meant cultivating food in challenging conditions. That's led to breakthroughs in the way food is grown, monitored, and conserved on Earth. Just three examples of dozens of technological breakthroughs, kickstarted by research on board the space station, which are already having an economic impact on Earth. Space is becoming a part of our culture, our commerce, our community. And new markets are emerging as we learn what's really possible when we build a new home beyond our planet. Creating a world where living, working, and exploring space is as familiar to humanity as life on our home planet. With the ISS, we have truly colonized low Earth orbit. Commercial flights are already providing services. And the next generation of orbiting space stations will become even more science-focused. Low Earth orbit is becoming an increasingly commercial destination. At ESA, we see significant opportunity for sustained business research with industrial partners. It's time to welcome you on board. My name is Andreas Mogensen, and I'm an engineer and scientist who lives and works in orbit. It's a journey that started for me as a child. Join us on the journey that keeps moving humanity forwards and outwards as our remarkable society expands off Earth. Together, we're becoming a spacefaring species. What will you do in orbit for your business, for humanity? The only limit is your imagination.